टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स ऑफ चैप्टर 5 दैट इज़ वर्किंग इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस एक्सेल यूजिंग ऑटोसम सॉर्टिंग एंड फॉर्मूले। देर आर वेरी एडवांस फीचर्स इन एक्सेल विच कैन बी यूज फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स टाइप्स ऑफ कैलकुलेशंस, बट वी विल बिगिन विद द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ सिंपल थिंग्स टू फैमिलियराइज आवरसेल्व्स विद एक्सेल। सेकेंड टॉपिक इज यूजिंग द ऑटोसम। The autosum option provides an easy and quick method to calculate the sum of selected range of data. Activity 7. To use the autosum feature to find the sum of scores by a batsman. Here are some steps you have to follow, these steps one by one. So first step is click on the empty cell after the last entry of the range of cells for which you want to find the total. Second step is click on the home tab. Now step number 3 is click on the autosum button. This is autosum button. Now step 4 is the formula for the sum of a range of numbers above it will appear in the active cell. Step 5 is press the enter key to accept the formula and display the sum. Activity 8. To find the sum of marks scored by all students using AutoSum. First step is select the range of cells where the sum has to be calculated. Second step is click on the AutoSum button. This is AutoSum button. The sum for the selected cells will be calculated. Now moving to the next topic, sorting of data. Using the sort option, the data can be arranged in ascending or descending order as required. Activity 9. To sort the given data based on a column, here name. First step is select the data to sort. Second step is click on the home tab. Click on the sort and filter arrowhead button. This is sort and filter arrowhead button. Okay. Third step is select the custom sort option. This is custom sort option. Fourth step is the sort dialog box opens. Now fifth step is from the sort by drop down list select the field name, here name, on which you want to sort the data. This is sort dialog box. Okay. Step 6 is from the order drop down list select the ascending A to Z or descending Z to A order. Okay, this is order drop down list. You have to select any one of them, A to Z or Z to A. A to Z means ascending order and Z to A means descending order. The data will be sorted as specified. Remember, if your data does not have a header like name, age, marks, deselect the My Data Has Headers checkbox option in the sort dialog box. Quick quiz. How is sorting of data useful? Give an example. Here is a suggestion. Teachers can explain to students if the selected data to sort is alphanumeric. The sorting option will be displayed as A to Z or Z to A. And if the selected data is numeric, the sorting option will be displayed as smallest to largest or largest to smallest. Moving to the next topic, that is using formulae. Excel provides you with some really simple but powerful features and facilities to enter the formulae to get even complex calculations done without any difficulty. You can build up formulae using the mathematical operators. The mathematical operators are plus, minus, division, multiplication, percent, and exponentiation. Addition 5 plus 2 plus 55, 62. Subtraction 89 minus 78 equals to 11. Division 125 divided by 5 equals to 25. Multiplication, 7 into 6 equals to 42. Percent, 3% equals to 0.3. Exponentiation, 4 exponentiation 2 equals to 16. Next topic is entering a formula. You always enter a formula starting with an equal to sign. For example, equal to C11 plus D11 plus E11 is a valid formula which will add up the values stored in the cell addresses C11, D11 and E11. If you do not place the equal to sign before the formula, the expression will be taken as the label alphanumeric entry. Copying a formula. A formula in a cell can be copied easily in other cells with two options. Option first is either changing the cell address according to where it has been copied. This is called the relative referencing. Second is or keeping the cell address constant where it is being copied. This is called the absolute referencing. Let's learn first addressing, that is relative referencing. In relative referencing, when you copy a formula to different cells, the cell addresses in the formula change according to the rows and columns where the formula is being copied. Look at the given example. You can apply the formula equal to B2 plus C2 in the cell D2 to get the total for the values in the cells B2 and C2. You can simply copy this formula to the cells D3 to D6 to get the total marks obtained by other students as well. The cell addresses in the formula will be automatically change themselves according to the cell in which it is being copied. Remember, you can also drag the autofill handle to copy the formula in the rest of the cells. Now activity 10. To copy a formula to calculate the sum of the marks scored by all students. Step first is create the formula and select the cell. Second step is click on the home tab. Third step is click on the copy button. This is copy button. Fourth step is select the range of cells from D3 to D6. Fifth step is click on the paste button. This is paste button. Okay. The formula will be copied and the values will be calculated. You will notice that the cell address in the formula has been changed according to the row and the column in which it has been copied. Second referencing is absolute referencing. In absolute referencing, when you copy a formula to different cells, the cell address in the formula remains the same irrespective of where the formula is being copied. To make a cell address absolute, add a dollar sign before the row and column address of the cell in the formula. For example, the cell address $E$2 will remain the same in any of the cells wherever it is copied. Quick quiz. What is the difference between absolute and relative referencing? We have to answer it. Remember, an absolute address is the cell address that does not change. Activity 11 for absolute referencing. To show the use of absolute referencing while copying a formula, the complete procedure to copy the formula is as shown in the previous example. Just create the new formula as equal to B2 plus C2 plus $E$2. The cell address $E$2 remains the same even when the formula is copied to different locations since it has been marked as absolute. Third referencing is mixed referencing. The cell address where one component, row address or column address, is made absolute and the other not absolute, like $E2, $D$3, is called mixed referencing. Okay. Let's learn meaning of tough words. फर्स्ट वर्ड इज कॉम्प्लेक्स. कॉम्प्लेक्स मीन्स कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, जटिल. सेकेंड वर्ड इज फैमिलियराइज. फैमिलियराइज मीन्स गिव समवन नॉलेज और अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ समथिंग. फैमिलियराइज मीन्स परिचय कराना. थर्ड वर्ड इज क्विक. क्विक मीन्स मूविंग फास्ट और डूइंग समथिंग इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम. क्विक मीन्स तेजी से. फोर्थ वर्ड इज एम्प्टी. एम्प्टी मीन्स ब्लैंक. एम्प्टी मीन्स खाली. फिफ्थ इज असेंडिंग. असेंडिंग मीन्स इंक्रीजिंग इन साइज और इम्पोर्टेंस. असेंडिंग मीन्स और आरोही. असेंडिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स आरोही क्रम. सिक्स इज डिसेंडिंग. डिसेंडिंग मीन्स अवरोही. डिफिकल्टी. डिफिकल्टी मीन्स ट्रबल या कठिनाई. कॉन्स्टेंट. कॉन्स्टेंट मीन्स स्टेबल या स्थिर. इरेस्पेक्टिव. इरेस्पेक्टिव मीन्स रिगार्डलेस ऑफ या निरपेक्ष.